It was in response to a lot of my homeboys had EWF, which meant every woman's fantasy. I couldn't really put EMF because I don't go out with all men. I only go out with brothers. So that was just in response to them. If you can put this on your chest, I can put this on mine.
Let's look at the statistics.
But you're not
if
a brother.
There are only 7 black men for every 10 black women.
Yeah.
How do you feel about the fact that Kim is married to a black man?
Well, you know.
That's why people say that. I get it.
Kim, I don't mean any disrespect to you, but, you know, I think something's kind of gone kind of haywire in your brain. I mean,
I think there's something wrong with yours.
No, I'm a black woman dating black men. I'm not saying I'm every white man's fantasy, you
well,
know.
Well, my husband wouldn't find you attractive at all.
How you gonna say you every brother's fantasy and then turn around and be like, my husband wouldn't be attracted to at all? Well, your husband's not about to be attracted to you when I'm done with your face, Humpty Dumpty. You gonna be scrambled on this stage, Humpty Dumpty. The caucasity of it all. Alleluia, hallelujah, hallelujah. Gotta praise. No, she did not. Oh, no, she didn't. The Mademoiselle, and this is my channel, and today we are going to be doing a reaction video that one of you guys sent to my email. And what do I always say? Send the video to my suggestion box or my Discord. Please refrain from sending anything to my email because I get a lot of emails and I'm probably not going to get it, and those are for professional inquiries only. So of course everything you need is going to be down in the description box down below, and of course just make sure you just peep that for, you know, all the stuff that you guys always ask me about down in the comment section. So with that being said, we're going to get straight into the reaction. Make sure you guys smash that like button, smash that subscribe button, smash every button, you know, that can help a sister out. Let us see what we are watching today, because this is pretty interesting. As you guys can tell by the title, this white woman thinks that she's every black man's fantasy. So I was like, I gotta see this mess. The show is actually pretty old, and it has a lot to do with the relationship between black woman and white woman. So I'm gonna be pausing a lot. Get your tea, get your snacks, get everything you need, because it's gonna be some interesting commentary. I have not done one of these in such a long time. Oh my god. So oh my god, nostalgia. Let's hope I don't get mad.
Black men go to white women for the softness that they get from a black woman. Black woman has a weight problem. It's much more acceptable than a white woman.
Black women prefer to have like some meat on their bones.
More well-rounded.
Yeah, than true. Straight up and down.
Oh, it's already problematic. I should have got some wine for this shit. Did she just say black men come to white women for the softness? Black men, where y'all at? I need y'all to be raw and honest in the comment section, because I would love to hear that. It's the caucasity for me, huh? First of all, there's plenty of black women that are very soft and sensual. It ain't me though. But I'm very, very soft and sensual with my man though. Trust me, I'm very like, he just brings it out in me. Trust me, it's not an act, right? People also need to understand, right? And I feel like black men and all men need to understand. The type of man you are to your woman is going to determine the type of woman you get from her. Every woman is not the same to every man. And every person is not the same in every relationship. Whatever you think about a whole collective race of people or a whole collective type of person is not always gonna be correct, okay? This is why I try to refrain from being black men, be like Hispanic men, be like white men, be like, because I know that whoever I date is not gonna treat me the same as they probably treated their ex or whatever the case may be. That's why I don't be sitting there talking shit about people's exes and shit, because I don't know, they could have treated their ex like trash and then they treat me like royalty or vice versa, right? You're not gonna always bring out the same thing in the last person. You always have to keep that in mind, okay? So a lot of these men or a lot of these women that be thinking they getting something over on black women or black men, whatever the case may be, talk about, oh well, you don't get that softness in these black women. No, you probably didn't
bring the softness out of that black woman. She probably didn't feel like she could be vulnerable with you. She probably felt like you reminded her of her ancient daddy. Because a lot of these black men, sadly, and this one is a fact, this one actually comes from statistics, do not take care of their children. So that leads to a lot of neglect issues, whatever the case may be. So sometimes there's a lot of women that haven't dealt with that psychologically, haven't went to therapy for that. So when they see a lot of other black men, they feel like they can't trust them. They get in relationships with them. Listen, we all know how that goes. So it's like, what the hell? Yeah, whatever. Example. You see? Shut the fuck up. You guys get the point. You know, like sometimes you just gotta be with the right person to bring certain things out of you. And sometimes that just means that you're not with the right person.
Few women are close friends with a woman of another racial background.
True.
So today we wanted to explore the reasons why with Kathy Russell and Midge Wilson. They're the co-authors of a controversial new book called Divided Sisters.
Black women often think white women are nosy or not genuine in their comments or in their questions to them about something that's going on in the black world. And they think that often white women are asking these questions just because they're trying to get in their business.
Or to seem socially responsible or appropriate somehow.
Right.
That's an interesting one. I agree, but I've never really heard that. I'm so sorry, but someone that has the gall to be out here like weed whacking or fucking lowing mons at 3:30, I don't know why they didn't do that in the morning. That shit's annoying. Like really fucking annoying. So I'm so sorry if that's bothering you. But this is the thing. I never thought of that perspective. For me, I have a white best friend. One of my best friends white, but at the same time, I do not live in a predominantly white area. Everyone is either African American, Haitian American, like Jamaican American, or like Hispanic, like some sort of Hispanic American. So for the most part, I don't live around a lot of white people. The white people live in South Jersey or like North Jersey. I'm kind of like, I'm North Jersey, but I'm not like North. Like I'm like North, like but like Northeast. Jersey. So like I don't live around a lot of white people, so I'm not gonna have that many white friends, but I don't mind white people whatsoever. Like I really don't care. I can be friends with anyone. I could be friends with a brick wall because I can talk to anyone, right? But I do feel like a lot of white women, for real, I don't want to say nosy, but I feel like a lot of them can be sneaky and vindictive. Just like what she said, a lot of them do not ask genuine questions. I feel like a lot of them do ask questions just to be slick, and just to talk shit. Just like what that girl said in the beginning, which I forgot to address last time. I don't like how she was like, oh, it's acceptable for a white woman to be overweight instead of a black woman. That's very true, but bitch, don't say that shit. Like, I mean, I understand it's a focus group, but it's like, you know, it's shit like that. Make it seem like they're better than you. It's stuff like that I don't like. Personally, I haven't necessarily, you know, came across that with, you know, any white friends that I've made along the way. But my best friend is white. She's never done that to me. I've had other friends that I made that are white. They never done it to me, but other white people I've met in passing have done that shit. Like, they try to one-up you. They try to say things. They say slick shit. They'll try to make comments about your hair, your clothes, or where you come from. And it's like, it seems very intentional.
Cannot establish trust with African American women. They always feel like they hold something back. But what white women don't understand a lot of the time is that they unintentionally say things that hurt black women, or black women find ignorant. And
are you married to a black man?
Yes, I am.
Like, y'all see what I'm talking about? I'm not reaching. I'm really not reaching. Like, y'all understand what I'm talking about? It's the slickness. It's the slyness. It's the I'm better than you. I date black men. I choke on black dick.
Some black women feel that white women should stay with white men because there's so few black men to go around as it is. Temperance, would you feel that the white women should just date within their own race?
I'm sorry,
let me just pause and answer that before they answer it. I don't even understand why they were applauding. I didn't like the way she even like, I did, baby. Shut the fuck up. Second of all, I don't think anyone should be restricted from who they date. Date who you date because you love them. It should have nothing to do with race. It should have nothing to do with their ethnicity, nothing. Like, that shit is really annoying. But this situation right here, it seems very pandering. It seems very like, yeah, I'm with a black man. What about it, Del? Like, nigga, like, you want brownie points, nigga? You want to come to the cookout, bitch? Now you're not invited just because you think that you got you happy you got a zoo animal. That's exactly how she's making it sound. Like, she's making it come off as if she's so happy that she won a prize or something. Like, she did something. Like, the way she's coming off is not genuine. Just like what everyone said in the beginning, it's like, it's disingenuous. And the whole idea of there's not enough black men to go around, I think that's fucking ridiculous. I never understood that ideology. Not every black man wants wants to be married. Not every black woman wants to be married. Not every person wants to be married in general. There's plenty of people on earth for everyone, I believe. So that's just irrelevant.
You're probably a lovely person, but you're not every brother's fantasy. I'm sorry to tell you. I don't want to be
with the understanding that I really feel that way. It was just in response to my own homeboys and what they had on their chest, and I just did the same thing.
This is so funny. This is totally comical to me because, I mean, I don't know why. I mean, yeah, we're all beautiful people. We're all sisters. We're all the same sisterhood. But for, you know, you as a Caucasian woman to think that you are every brother's fantasy is stretching it, you know, to Pluto or someplace.
Yeah. I mean, what's your opinion?
Woo! Thank you. Like, have several seats. It's the grandioseness of it all. It's the cockiness. It's the trying to act like you're better than us. It's the, first of all, you're not even cute. Could we just talk about, like, the girl's not even cute. You look like Humpty Dumpty sat on the wall. Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. Okay, like, literally, that's what you look like. You're not even cute. Talk about some of your every brother's fantasy. What brother? Comment down below, brothers. Is that your fantasy? Is that your fantasy? Because I want to know. If that's your fantasy, I'll shut up right the fuck down. No, I ain't. This is my channel. That girl not even cute. Talk about some she every brother fantasy. I foot she thoughts. Tit down. Take a seat. This is shit I'm talking about. They are way too, like, out of this world. Child, duh. But honestly, I would have probably said exactly what I said there. I would have tried to keep it respectful because I'm on television. But no, you're not every brother's fantasy. Like, no. You are too ambitious for me, sweetheart. Sweetheart, take a seat. Shut up.
Let's look at the statistics.
But you're not a brother.
There are only 7 black men for every 10 black women.
Yeah.
How do you feel about the fact that Kim is married to a black man?
Well, you know.
That's why people say that. I get it.
Kim, I don't mean any disrespect to you, but, you know, I think something's kind of gone kind of haywire in your brain. I mean,
I think there's something wrong with yours.
No, I'm a black woman dating black men. I'm not saying I'm every white man's fantasy. You
well,
know.
My husband wouldn't find you attractive at all.
How you gonna say you every brother's fantasy and then turn around and be like, my husband wouldn't be attracted to at all? Well, your husband's not about to be attracted to you when I'm done with your face, Humpty Dumpty. You gonna be scrambled on this stage, Humpty Dumpty. The caucasity of it all. Alleluia, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Gotta praise. No, she did not. Oh, no, she didn't.
Yeah, and we are all women sitting up here trying to say what we believe.
Yeah.
For you to insult her,
right?
Then you know better. You know better. You get on national.
Are you kidding me?
Sally, you could take a seat. What was her name? I even see her name. I don't give a fuck what your name is. You could take a seat. How they coming at her? She said, I'm every brother's fantasy. And she said, girl, you are not every brother's fantasy. Is that an insult? That's not an insult.
You cannot make a definitive statement as in every brother's fantasy. That's not an insult.
You still insulted.
No, okay, I am not insulting anybody.
Is it typical?
Well, yes it is, and this is part of the divide, but what a lot of white women don't understand is they think that they're being positive race ambassadors by going out with black men, that black women will see them as non-prejudiced, and this is a good thing, and they think that they're...
Did you hear what she said? She said she's every black man's fantasy.
Bruh, like, come on. She says she's every black man's fantasy. She has a fucking tattoo that says she's every black man's fantasy. Can somebody explain to me what she did wrong here? Maybe I'm wrong too. Maybe I'm her type of breed and we all fucked up and we're the reason there's no woman unity. But I kid you not, I would have hit her. I probably would have hit her.
You said black and white women can be friends. Did your theory apply to all women of all races?
No. Let me clarify what I said. And before I clarify it, let me do one thing. Let me just tell you one quick thing. I'm an activist, you know, I'm not a racist, I have black friends, white friends, that's neither here nor there. But I just want to say one thing, I think women have a sisterhood, and we need to be very aware of that and respect each other. I was not trying to diss her or insult her. I only made one statement, that she was not every brother's fantasy, as none of us are every anybody's fantasy. So let's just clear that point up. That's all I was trying to say.
Are you jealous of Kim maybe because she has a good black man and you don't?
She didn't even put hands on nobody and they trying to literally paint her as this angry black woman. She didn't even say anything. Yo, this is a yo. I'm so upset right now. Are these people dense? This is so disrespectful. If anything, she insulted the black woman. Okay, the black woman in the audience, black woman in general, by sitting here talking about something. I'm every black man's fantasy. But what the fuck are you trying to say, bitch? The fuck are you trying to say? Humpty Dumpty looking ass bitch.
Yes, I am so jealous of Kim. You know, she kind of reminds me of, I don't know, Cindy Crawford. So yeah, I'm jealous of her.
Don't insult. Right. Now, you said the show's not about insult.
That was insult. I've been recommending her.
Don't you feel that you need to apologize to her for that? That was insult. That's not visually ghetto, is it?
Likes me the way that I am.
And that's a good thing. You know what? I just want to say one, I want to stick to one thing that I was saying. We are all women here. We're all sisters. I'm not here to do it. Excuse me. Excuse me. I'm not here.
You know what? I'm very sure this episode was way longer. If I can ever find the whole entire episode, we are going to dissect this shit live. I really, can someone please send me the whole entire episode? This one y'all can send to my email. How dare they come at this woman? How dare they?
A good black man who doesn't. Be thankful if you have someone
because
in your life that loves you no matter what.
I have a black man.
Well, what do you think this is about?
I think this is about some unresolved feelings, some very hurtful feelings. You, Temperance, sound like you are in so much pain. Your anger is just, I mean.
Well, thank you,
Bobby,
amateur, you know, psychologist.
It's when I'm amateur.
No, but I mean, you don't know me. Listen, I'm not here to insult anybody, you know, so let's just be clear about that. Yeah.
First of all, Temperance.
Yo, am I in the Twilight Zone? I don't think Temperance did anything wrong. I'm gonna save my, I need to watch the rest of this.
Right, it is a major source of tension between white women and black women, this issue of sexual competition because of the shortage of African American men and because of the different standards of beauty. White women are thrown up as the ideal, the blue-eyed blonde woman, and African American women are grow up with that, and it pains them to see that as the ideal, especially when African American men.
The more
successful many an African American man becomes, many of them turn to a white woman as a trophy wife. We know this happens. We can look at a lot of
you also have myths about black women, about black women's sexuality, and
right.
Not coming solely from the type of societal things that we have to deal with, but within the black community, we black women deal all the time with what is beautiful, what is not.
Right.
Is natural hair more beautiful than processed hair? Or braids? But I mean, so that it is a problem.
That was stressful. I'm genuinely annoyed that they tried that girl like that. That was pretty damn ridiculous. I want to find the full episode and I will watch that. We watch that shit live with popcorn and wine and all that, because they was coming for my girl Temperance a little bit too much. You guys are probably commenting down below, but Temperance this, Temperance that, I don't know. Maybe, I don't know anything about Temperance, never heard of Temperance. I heard she's an activist. And since that she's against interracial dating, I'm not about that. I don't like that. I think everyone should be able to date who they want to. The whole shortage of black men thing is ridiculous. Like, everyone should be able to date who you want. Why are you only trying to date black men? Date other people. I love my Haitian men, but there's white Haitians. Shit, a white Haitian man was to come to me and I was single, why not, right? Like, who cares? You know, like, there's different men in the sea, people. Open your horizons. I think that was very problematic. I do feel like Temperance did start to catch a little attitude towards the end, but I feel like she was definitely being antagonized by that entire show, from the people on the panel to the people in the audience to the damn host as well. Do you think he should apologize? No, the fuck. She should not. All right, with that being said, I'd love to know what you guys think about this video down below. What do you guys think about Temperance? What do you guys think about Miss I'm Every Brother's Dream? What do you guys think about that panel? What do you guys think about that show? Can anyone please find me the full episode? That would be greatly appreciated. With that being said, make sure you guys like, share, subscribe, follow my two channels right over here. And yeah, peep the description box, and I'm gonna see y'all next time. Bye.